And you gotta think that somewhere Dean Malenko and Chris Benoit are watching right now. Because on their way to the ring, the man who cost them the World Tag Team Championships, Perry Saturn, and the enigmatic one himself, Raven.
And those four competitors will meet at Spring Stampede 99 live on pay-per-view 1 week from tomorrow from the Tacoma Dome. It's going to be a non-title match because of the title switch this past Monday on Nitro, with Rey Mysterio Jr. and Kidman capturing the titles. But also as a part of Spring Stampede, there will be a cruiserweight title match where the new champ Mysterio must defend that cruiserweight singles belt against his tag team partner Kidman.
An unprecedented situation. I'm sure it's happened in distant history in WCW, but it's been a long time since we've seen tag team champions face each other inside the squared circle. It will go down 1 week from tomorrow night in Tacoma at the Tacoma Dome at Spring Stampede 99. Ray Jr. and Kidman for the Cruiserweight Championship.
And I'm still trying to figure out the circumstances that would reunite these two men. The falling out that they had when they were both Flock members. We all remember that it was Saturn that realistically led to the Flock being disbanded, and now they have joined forces as a tag team, really without explanation, Scott.
They haven't said a word to anyone about what led to their reformation. They've been friends since childhood. We've known that. They went to high school together. They were at the Barbed Wire City Bingo Hall together. But in WCW, they had a massive falling out in 1998. And it lasted until just a couple of weeks ago. But now Raven and Perry Saturn are a formidable tag team. Make no mistake about it.
And when Gene Okerlund attempted to question the two this past Thursday on Thunder about the reasons behind the reunion, they were very evasive. They tap danced around all the questions, just like Raven is so famous for doing. I just see this as Raven trying to control a set of circumstances here where he wants Rey Mysterio Jr. and Kidman to be the tag team champions. He claims that he has a dislike for Benoit and Malenko, but I think that Raven feels that it's the proper avenue for him and Saturn to take on Mysterio and Kidman and win the tag team belts.
That is excellent analysis from the professor. Raven, for all of his protestations that he is some sort of tortured soul, we know his background. The exclusive gated community in Palm Beach, Florida. The money belonging to his family. We know where he came from. Nobody's buying this grunge act anymore. He's a smart man.
And we've been concentrating so much on Saturn that we should remind fans in the Philadelphia, Pennsylvania area that WCW returns to the First Union Spectrum on May the 1st. Tickets will go on sale this upcoming Friday, April the 9th, at the First Union Center box office and all Ticketmaster outlets. Plus, you have the opportunity to meet Bam Bam Bigelow and Saturn.
Wow.
That'll be from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. at the Tower Records store in Cherry Hill, New Jersey, right next to Philly.
Memo to the security guys at the First Union Spectrum. Be very careful if you've got Bam Bam and Saturn in the same place.
That's at the Tower Records, actually, where Bigelow and Saturn will be on April the 9th. But yes, the event will be at the First Union Center.
Saturn and Raven. Scott Armstrong, whoa, took a right hand from Raven. And Saturn's got a new dress.
Oh, is that what that is?
Just noticed.
Maybe it's just the skirt that he has that's new, huh?
Maybe. I'm not, obviously not one for fashion, but Perry Saturn apparently is.
You talked about the long history that Saturn and Raven have together. You can certainly not say the same for their opponents. Because to my knowledge, this is the very first time that Silver King has ever teamed with Scott Armstrong. You talk about two very different styles. Maybe that'll help them in the long run against Saturn and Raven.
Drop toe hold. Silver King takes the elbow from Raven. And I gotta wonder, why would Perry Saturn and Raven take a match with Silver King and Scott Armstrong, two men who have never teamed before to our knowledge, and two men who most definitely don't represent something close to what Chris Benoit and Dean Malenko could bring to the ring.
Well, I'm sure that just it's an effort for Saturn and Raven to work together as a tag team. You realize that it's been a long time since they have been together. It gives them a chance, I think, to get fluid as a tag team, with the long-term thought being that they will be facing Benoit and Malenko at Spring Stampede.
While Raven is being double-teamed and pummeled out there by Scott Armstrong and Silver King, Perry Saturn was jawing with the referee. Now Saturn finally chases them off, and referee Charles Robinson one more time in the midst of controversy here.
Plenty of great action yet to come on WCW Saturday night, including the dog-faced gremlin Rick Steiner to go one-on-one with Fit Finley. What a brawl that's going to be, an excellent super kick from Silver King, and the clothesline as Armstrong and Silver King double team on Raven.
Rick Steiner and Fit Finley to meet later. Oh, hang on, lateral press. Raven barely out at two. Steiner and Finley, that's a rematch from Nitro at Club La Vila in Panama City Beach, Florida.
And that's not all, because also yet to come this evening, that tag team match, you might call it a return bout, I guess, from Thursday on Thunder. Hugh Morris and the Barbarian against Ming and Jerry Flynn, although Ming and Flynn really never had a chance to team up. Two count that time by Armstrong on Raven.
Raven is really being hammered in there by Silver King and Scott Armstrong. And I'm suspicious. Perry Saturn hasn't tried to make the save for his partner here. I wonder if everything is just as peaches and cream as it would appear between Saturn and Raven.
Well, when you see Raven and when you see Saturn, you know that you can never judge by what you see on the surface. There's always, I'm sure, some underlying problems or heat between these two. Cover by Silver King and a two count on Raven.
Raven barely out, and Perry Saturn at ringside. Just look at Saturn. Just doesn't appear all that concerned.
Maybe it's that friction between these two that puts them on the edge and makes them a better tag team.
Front slam from Silver King. Raven is out. Silver King is going to the top turnbuckle. High flyer. No, the senton backsplash did not connect. Raven, that was the last bit of energy I think he had left. Slowly makes his way over, and there's the tag to Perry Saturn. Starts off with a kick to the gut of Scott Armstrong. Oh, here we go. Belly to belly release, overhead suplex. Backs Silver King into the corner. Whoa, what a suplex from Saturn.
He just T-boned Silver King out of the corner, and now he's got Scott Armstrong in trouble.
In the corner mount, reining in the right hands on Scott Armstrong. Perry Saturn. Now Raven's back in there. Right hands to Silver King. They're going to double-team the Luchador back into the corner. One more time. Good teamwork from Perry Saturn and Raven. They shoot him across. Double leg sweep into a clothesline. Lateral press. Oh, and Scott Armstrong breaks it up at two.
Now that's teamwork. What a move in the corner by Raven and Saturn. Armstrong out to the floor. Two legal men are in the ring. There's the even flow.
That has got to do it. With the even flow DDT, Raven and Perry Saturn. What a team. They will meet Chris Benoit and Dean Malenko at Spring Stampede. This one is going to be worth another look, Mike. Let's do it in our Castrol Motor Oil replay of the week. Castrol Motor Oil. Motor oil that provides maximum protection. Castrol, drive hard. Let's go back and take another look at what went down early.
Well, in the early going, Scott Armstrong and Silver King were dominating this matchup against Raven. Saturn came in with an assist and caught that leg drop on Silver King. Then it was the belly-to-belly, the overhead release suplex on Scott Armstrong delivered by Saturn. He followed up the advantage with a running clothesline on Silver King and brought him out of the corner with a T-bone suplex. It was Saturn throwing both Silver King and Scott Armstrong all over the ring before Raven punctuated matters with the even flow DDT, the ensuing three count, and Saturn and Raven score the win on the way to Spring Stampede.